The lava flow from Ayón volcano continues to extend farther from its crater. Our very own Irene Perol now joins us to tell us what this means for Albay residents. Irene.
Hermina, 257 rockfall events, 6 dome collapse pyroclastic density current events, and 1 lava front collapse pyroclastic density current event was recorded by Philippine Institute of Volcanology and Seismology over Mayon volcano for the past 24 hours. The lava flow from the crater continues and has reached 2.8 kilometers along Miisi Gali, 1.3 kilometers along Bunga Gali, and the farthest reach is along Basut Gali at 4 kilometers. FIVOX has advised that should the lava flow reach 6 kilometers from the crater, those living within the extended 7 to 8 kilometers will need to be evacuated. The local government of Legazpi City has set up its Incident Management Team Command Post and are on standby for emergency evacuation of residents living within the extended danger zone. At present, 6,183 families or 21,741 persons are displaced from 7 local government units in Albay. Legazpi is not included in the list as they have relocated those living inside the 6-kilometer permanent danger zone. But should there be an extension of the danger zone, the city government has prepared its budget for assistance for those who will be displaced. Carmina?
Thanks a lot. Our correspondent there, Irene Perol, joining us on the line. Labor Secretary Bienvenido Laguesma says his agency will not oppose Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri's proposal for a 100 peso legislated minimum wage increase. But he says the additional increase on top of the recently announced 40 peso wage hike should be balanced with the interests of businesses.
Tayo po ay hindi kumokontra kasi ang pagpapanukala po ng mga batas, yan po ay mandato ng ating legislatura. Ang napakahirap na trabaho ng atin pong Regional Tripartite Wages and Productivity Board ay balansehin yung kakayahan din ng mga namumuhunan, lalo na't ating isa sa alang-alang na karamihan po ng ating mga negosyo ay nandun po sa kategorya ng micro and small enterprises.
Philippine state auditors flagged the office of the vice president for skipping procurement laws. The OVP purchased property and equipment worth over 660,000 pesos using its officers' money. They were then paid through reimbursement. The audit commission says this process defeats the purpose of procurement laws. The OVP's financial statements also show a spike in confidential expenses from zero in 2021 to 125 million in 2022. State auditors also flagging the Metro Manila Development Authority over unfinished flood control projects worth more than 800 million pesos. The commission said the MMDA failed to implement 33 of its 47 projects and programs by the end of 2022. The MMDA acknowledged the delay in the projects, but it said the longer procurement process for foreign-funded projects caused the delay. It added some of the projects in question were started when the pandemic hit the country, while the others were covered by the election ban, which contributed to more delays. A congressional inquiry into the Philippine tourism campaign mess inevitable. Albay Representative Joey Salceda says the campaign has drawn a bad image for the country and placed the tourism department in a tight spot. The tourism department on Monday ended its contract with DDB Group Philippines after the ad agency apologized for using stock footage of other countries in the video launching the Love the Philippines campaign. Salceda believes the slogan would likely be changed following the controversy, but Salceda says he will move on from the issue for now.
Para sa akin, move on na dapat ako, move forward. My attitude now is really to help her, help the DOT, kasi tayo rin nasasaktan. We keep shooting ourselves in our own foot by, you know, proceeding with this controversy that gets highlighted globally and shows, you know, a very difficult position for the Philippines. So I'd rather help. So sabi ko, let's follow the law. Let's consult.
Metro Pacific Investment Corporation moves ahead with its plan to delist from the Philippine Stock Exchange. The Manny Pangilinan-led firm sought for a trading suspension Tuesday morning after its board approved the move, and the consortium of shareholders that want to take the company private submitted an updated tender offer notice. The consortium, made up of Metro Pacific Holdings, GD Capital, and two other firms, offered what it called the best and final price of 5 pesos and 20 centavos per share. The tender offer values MPIC at 149.2 billion pesos.
I think it's really a big improvement from the original 4.63 bid price that they originally offered investors. So I guess this is welcoming now for a lot of the people who would like to probably tender their shares. So I think the biggest shareholders, from what we estimated, would probably their cost would be below 5. So I think there would be a more compelling reason now for them to really tender their share. So I think that should be good news for Metro Pacific. However, for the broader market, again, it's another stock that is taken out of and reducing liquidity in the overall market.
The Philippine Stock Exchange eyes launching short selling in the market by the fourth quarter of this year. Speaking to ANC's Business Outlook, PSC President and CEO Ramon Monzon said they are polishing the guidelines and waiting for the approval of several agencies. Stock market investors have been pushing for short selling for years, which allows investors and traders to make money from a down market. This means investors can borrow stocks and sell them in the open market, then buy the shares back for less after the price falls, allowing them to earn from the difference.
I don't see an immediate, volatility caused by the short selling. Mm-hmm. Like, I was pushing, or I'm pushing for short selling, not for speculation or any other, reason, except for the fact that this is one of the more important ways to attract back foreign investors.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Because we only have a long market. So like right now, you see foreign investors are looking with disfavor, not only the Philippines, mm-hmm. but the whole region. But except, in the other markets, they don't have to exit. They can hedge their investments.
Right.
So they don't sell.
Mm-hmm.
In the Philippines, we're a long only market. We have no short selling. They have no choice but to sell out, instead of being able to hedge their investments.
Five more suspects in the killing of Negros Oriental Governor Roel de Gamo formally recant their earlier statements, pinning embattled lawmaker Arnulfo Teves Jr. to the crime. Now, this brings to 10 the total number of suspects who have withdrawn their testimonies. The 11th suspect and alleged ringleader of the group, Marvin Miranda, did not execute any affidavit. The camp of the De Gamo family not bothered by the latest development.
Sa balita na nagrecant na yung 10 shooters, hindi naman po kami nababahala dyan dahil unang-una hindi naman namin kailangan ang kanilang testimonya o kooperasyon para we can prosecute these cases successfully. Pero assuming po, no? Sige, nandyan yung recantation nila. Tandaan po natin na sa judicial affidavit, merong 3 tao na involved dyan. Nandyan yung examining officer, yung nagtanong sa kanila at yung nagbigay ng sagot, of course, yung affiant, at saka yung nagnotaryo. So kung gagamitin po natin yung dati na nilang 4 na salaysay bago sila magrecant, ay pwede po nating ipresenta bilang witness yung examining officer. Pagka ipresenta po natin lahat yan sa korte, merong pamantayan yung huskado kung sino at alin ang kanyang paniniwalaan. Mataas yung paniniwala natin na justice will be served by our court and the victims and the families of the victims will attain justice.
The University of the Philippines community sounding the alarm over the reported sexual assault of a student inside the Diliman campus. Our very own Vivian Gulia has that story for us.
A male student of the University of the Philippines Diliman was reportedly sexually assaulted inside the campus last weekend. UPD Chancellor Edgardo Carlo Vistan II says the student was on her way home around 11 Saturday night. She was walking on Ilanan Street to exit at Commonwealth Avenue when an unidentified man carrying a bladed weapon approached and attempted to rape her. According to the police, from this sidewalk, the suspect forced the victim to enter this area by pointing a bladed weapon at her. The site of the crime is covered with grass, and huge tree trunks almost block the visibility of the area. Vistan says from their information, the attempt to rape the student was prevented when people passed by the street, but the perpetrator managed to escape.
May mga security personnel na eventually nakita siya. Kaya napigil yung assault at a certain time na naiwasan pa kung anumang pwede mangyari. Wala sa information namin any indication that she was raped. Kasi nga may mga narinig na paparating at kumaripas na ng takbo yung umatake sa kanya. The community is shocked, no? And very alarmed, and our heart goes out for the victim, for the survivor, and her family.
May mga injury siya sa katawan, sa paa, sa tiyan, sa kamay, and we're still in the process of conducting investigation.
The student was immediately brought to the University Health Service for treatment. She filed a complaint before the UP Diliman Police, which turned it over to the Quezon City Police District. Medical examinations, initial psychological and mental support were given. The police continue to gather evidence to determine the identity of the perpetrator, estimated to be around 5'3 in height, slim, and wore cargo shorts and black jacket at the time of the incident.
Look into CCTVs na possible na nakakatch ng nangyaring ito, pati ng mga dashcam ng mga dumadaang sasakyan. We'll be looking into more evidence to establish the identity of the attacker. Well, based on the evidence na nakita namin, may mga fingernail examination yung victim. Matingnan natin yung kanyang iba pang mga ebidensya na makuha natin. I think hindi naman natin masabing tiyak na tiyak, pero malaki ang chance. Science, masa-science natin tong case na to. There are physical evidence left on the victim. So, sumuko siya. Yeah, much better siguro, mitigating circumstance yan. Kung hindi siya sumuko, ganun pa rin. Mahuhuli rin naman siya.
The incident sparked alarm from members of the UP community.
Tinatanaw po kasi namin ang campus namin bilang isang ligtas na espasyo, kung saan ang mga estudyante ay malayang makapaglakad, makaikot ng campus. Panawagan sa administration ng UP na mas magkaroon ng maayos na safety and security protocols.
Nabigla po ako. Kailangan din po talaga mag-ingat ng, especially ng mga girls po, kahit within the campus. Pagdadala po ng mga bagay na magagamit po for self-defense. Pepper spray po or anything na pwede pong ipanghampas.
Vistan gave the assurance that the UP administration is beefing up security in the campus, increasing the roving presence of security personnel, and cutting down some trees blocking the view in parts of the sidewalk where the assault happened. The school administration also plans to consult the community regarding the possibility of installing CCTVs in the area.
Ang isa naming iniisip, no, and moving forward is to perhaps provide transportation to people who want to pass by that area by a certain time, and to make sure that we give all the protection that our students and anyone passing through those areas need, considering na nga itong nangyari.
The UP Diliman administration says it is ready to extend all possible assistance to the student, while the Commission on Higher Education expressed deep concern and full support for the victim survivor. CHED Chairperson Prospero De Vera III says the crime should be a wake-up call for UP to review and rationalize its security and safety policies, including its operational engagement with the Philippine National Police and other law enforcement agencies, in order to make the UP community safe and secure. Under an accord between UP and the DILG, prior notification should be given before the conduct of any police operation inside UP campuses. QCPD, for its part, says it is ready to provide security assistance if UP Diliman requests it. Students and members of the community are urged to stay vigilant and report anything suspicious to the UPDP. Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.
For the Quezon City Police, the sexual assault case inside UP Diliman is an isolated incident. Police say they have already identified a person of interest. They're now urging him to surrender.
The UP campus is still a very safe community. Mga kanyan eh, yan yung mga aberrations eh. This incident I can consider this as isolated. Nangyari lang ito dahil nagkaroon lang talaga ng confluence of events. Hindi naman ito normal na nangyayari. So, meron lang talagang isang siraulo na nag-take advantage.